सदाशिव समारंभा शंकराचार्य मध्यमा अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरा। Today's subject is Unlock Your Brain's Potential if you have it. I'll introduce few truths about brain. Before that, brain is physical grass blueprint of your mind. Please understand, brain itself is not mind, it's a blueprint of your mind. I wanted to introduce few of the truths about the consciousness, mind and brain. If I give you an example, sun reflecting on the mirror. The sun is the consciousness. The reflection is mind. The mirror on which, the part of the mirror on which the reflection is happening, that area is brain. Consciousness is sun. The reflection itself is mind. The area of the mirror on which the reflection is happening is brain. By awakening the non-mechanical parts of your brain, you create a clean mirror for the reflection to be more pure, reflection to be more true to the consciousness. When you clean the mirror, the reflection, mind, can be more true to consciousness. When you clean the mirror, the reflection can be more true to sun. If there is a misshape, dust or part of the mirror which does not reflect properly, the reflection will not be true to the sun. So awakening your brain, non-mechanical parts of the brain, and keeping it clean and alive will make your mind true to the consciousness. Making your mind true to the consciousness is enlightenment. If your mind can reflect consciousness as it is, without adding or deleting, illusion or delusion, you are living enlightenment. The other day I was reading an article, very beautiful information, truth. The highest achievements done by a human being in the weightlifting or the bench press powers and all that, with all the training and everything, in Guinness record, is much lower than the same setup gorilla's bench press power. The same brain, body, almost same. Gorillas carry the same structure. Their bench press power is something like 4,000. The human beings with all their training, the gorillas' bench press power is 4,000 without any training, are trying to be stronger. With human beings, with all the training, everything, it is not even 1/4. Why, you know, first thing we forget our strength. See, gorilla never tries to be stronger. He is just be himself, that's all. In our case, we forget our strength. Set a wrong trend. From that wrong stand, we try to be stronger. That is where the struggle starts. Even with our brain, the same thing. Basically, we start believing it can function only if the informations go inside. Our basic education system, which makes you believe you will not know which you are not taught. You will not know which is not put inside systematically through eyes or ears, is the most dangerous and wrong belief system goes inside. Your brain is not a computer which can process only the information which is fed inside. It is like the brain can be used in the other way, like a computer to access the internet where everything is available, just download. You use your brain like an ordinary PC where whatever informations are fed, that can be processed, developed, and result can be given. That is not the truth. That is not the potential of your brain. Use that as a computer to download all the information available in all internet. Your brain is like a computer given to you. Either you can use it as a PC or you can use it as a computer with internet connection. You are taught from the young age it is a PC. No, which is not true. It is a computer with internet connection, where you can download any information available in internet, means in the world. Your brain is not created to receive information, process and respond. No, it has the cosmic connection. All you need to remember, need to know is, by nature you have a cosmic connection. And you can go on downloading anything you want and sharing it with the world. I remember a very powerful incident happened in my life. One day, very playfully, all my classmates wanted to have a debate with me. Some questions they asked about Ganesha. I answered very strongly. Then one fellow said, he talks as if he knows everything. The other fellow said, no, he knows everything. And then they said, all right, tomorrow we will come up with question. We will ask any question you answer, we will give you 5 rupees. Those days 5 rupees is a big money. And any question I am not able to answer, I have to give 5 rupees. Some 10 boys gathered. I went to Kuppammal. She told me, go and attend. Nothing to be afraid. Go and do it. Somehow I had the confidence. And I did not even have the thought, if I don't know some answer, what will I do? Anyhow, I went and they started question, putting all kinds of questions, went on and on and on. I was answering. Suddenly one very tricky question came. See, in Thiruvannamalai, there is a small temple on the Pearl Hill, means Pavalakkundru, on that there is a small temple. The whole city believes the temple as a Subramanya temple because only for Subramanya's function, people will go there and have darshan and come. And always on the top of the hill, only Subramanya's temple will be there in Tamil Nadu. They just asked me one question. That temple, they celebrate the Subramanya celebration. Is it Subramanya's temple? Whole village and the whole, everybody knows it is only Subramanya temple. Before answering, I just looked in. I saw very clearly the point which I call as balance. If you just put a rod between your ears and a rod through your third eye, where the two rods meet, that point is called balance. I saw very clearly that balance opening up and the information getting downloaded. No, it is not Subramanya temple, it is Ardhanarishwara's temple. Subramanya's shrine is also there, but the main deity is Ardhanarishwara. And I tell you honestly, never that information was fed into me through eyes or through ears, because I had never been inside the temple's Garbhamandir before, or never I heard from somebody it is Ardhanarishwara's temple. Never ever the information was fed to me through eyes or through ears. If you open the channel of receiving the information where the eyes and ears meet, that is what I call internet connection. The balance, the sixth sense, if the balance has access to information, it is internet connection. Your eyes are like web camera. Your ears are like speaker in the computer. You all know only how to use the eyes and ears and the keyboard. You miss the internet connection. By nature, you have the internet connection in you all. Just because you are breathing, you have internet connection. And there is no website which you can't access. There is no firewall. There is no security. You can access anything without getting corrupt or without getting infected by virus. Any information can be accessed and handled. I saw very clearly that information being happening, and I responded. One boy who was there, he got really frightened, because any normal person goes to the temple, usually the temple will be open only during some celebration. During that celebration time, always the Subramanya will be kept in the front. So nobody will have the access to the Garbhamandir to go and even have a look of the original deity. You are shocked. And I saw really that fellow got shaken so much. He never thought, I'll know such a intricate information, fact, such deep fact, because he is from a Brahmin family who does puja of the temple. So he thought, except his family, nobody knows it is a Ardhanarishwara temple. And actually itself nobody knows. Even now in the village, in the city, it is considered only as a Subramanya temple. He said, how do you know? Only we people who enter the Garbhamandir know. It's Ardhanarishwara. It's not Subramanya. I said, Are, You enter Garbha Mandir every day and come out. I am inside Garbha Mandir. How will I not know? I said it so spontaneously, not with thinking or ego or arrogance or nothing. I said it so spontaneously, just as a casual. The spontaneous truth, you see, when gorilla is expressing 4000 bench press power, he is not trying to be egoistic. He is just a gorilla. He is just he himself. That's all. So when I revealed that information, when I said, I am just myself, that's all. There is no pride or excitement or escalation or ego or arrogance. No. I just said, I am there. I never thought this is an extraordinary power. Only after this debate, I realized this is an extraordinary power. It is actually not extraordinary if you are not made as ordinary by your schools and the initial level people with whom you live. The first 14 years with whom you live plays a major role on your life. Kids should not live with dull people first 14 years. I tell you, first 14 years you should live in an enlightened community. Last 20 years you should live with the in a place where people live for a long time without depression. Understand? This two period, this first 14 years, if you live in a community where the intelligence, knowledge-based community, your life will be the best in the world. If you live the last 20 years in a community where people live long without depression, means you accepted the aging gracefully. If you have depression, you have not accepted aging gracefully. If you are sick and not living healthily, you are not aging gracefully. Healthy, peaceful, happy old age. If you are able to live in that kind of a community, understand, your death will be the great gift. This is what I call cosmic airport, where the landing and takeoff happens in a very intelligent way. Small mistake in landing will be an accident. Small mistake in taking off will be an accident. The first 14 years, kids should live in a place where many computers have internet access. Many brains have the balance access, the sixth sense access. One important thing you need to know. In the internet, if you give only the LAN connection, all computers will have the access to the internet. In computers. In brain, even if 5-6 brains have the cosmic connection, if 10 more people are added to live in that place, all the other 10 will automatically pick it up. You don't need anything. Just all other 10 will automatically pick it up. Some of the researchers say that in a village where this polio prevention drops are given, if you give just 40% of the kids, all other 60% of the kids automatically get immune. In the 100 kids, if you just give 40 kids the medicine and come away, All other 60 kids, not only they have not taken medicine, they don't even know about the medicine, but their body gets developed in such a way, automatically they get immune. So there is something between the kids which transmits the energy and understanding. Unfortunately, the kid's body and mind always gets tuned to the highest possibility. When you grow up, you are always in tune with the lowest possibility. You see 10 people, wow, even this worst way I can live, that's great. Then catch the worst thing. That is why the adult communities are always failure. Because when you enter the community, you find out the lowest possibility and you put that as a benchmark and tune yourself and happy. But the kids, they catch the highest possibility and imbibe that. So the first 14 years, kids living in a place where more people have awakened or working on awakening the non-mechanical parts of the brain will do so much good, which cannot even be told by words. Just living, see, accessing the cosmic information center is not like a technique need to be taught step by step. Just if the kids know, wow, this kind of a person, extraordinary intelligence exists, that's all they need to know. That conviction is the internet access, that's all. Now the information which I said, that like this I had access to the information which was not fed to me through the eyes or ears, if they know that, that's enough. Their sixth sense, the balance, will just get awakened and will start functioning, and you will see in few days they also start expressing informations which was never fed to them through brain, sorry, through the hearing or seeing. Over. I am opening up a great new possibility. Our Gurukul system is nothing but awakening the non-mechanical parts of the brain, that internet access. That's all. Ordinary education system, the Western education system, the book-based education system, the information education system, information-based education system, teaches you how to use your brain as a computer, personal computer, PC. But N-based education system, the Gurukul system, which I am creating, teaches you how to use your brain, use your computer as the internet access system. When you awaken the balance, the sixth sense, with a simple reminding you, it is your inborn tendency, innate intelligence, nothing else. You are with it. Just do it. You'll see the kids will start using their brain more like computer with internet access, where the informations are available which is not fed through that computer. Any information, any knowledge created at any time in the planet Earth is available. All you need is plug the internet connection and know that you can access and download and process. The balance, the sixth sense, is not just World Wide Web, it is Cosmos Wide Web, CWW. It's not WWW. Any information created at any time can be accessed, processed, and delivered. Simple understandings, clarity, giving them the courage. First thing, kids should not be brought up by the people who themselves believe their brain is like personal computer. Means they themselves have become corrupt. The corrupt people should not bring up the kids. Kids should be brought up by the people who realize that they are internet, they have internet connection, or at least they understand they have some part they are not able to access. That's all. Then you will see kids happen without losing their non-mechanical parts of the brain's power. And they will happen without losing their basic intelligence. They will happen just with their nature. Just this reminding will keep them awake, keep their non-mechanical parts alive, awake. Kundalini alive, awake. And when they have some 3-4 miracles happening in their life, I tell you this one miracle in my life which happened, I realized, oh God, I am talking about the information which was never fed inside me. I am expressing information which was never fed inside me. The tremendous confidence which came in me made that Kundalini are permanent in my biomemory. It's not like, it's like a wireless internet access. First experience like a card, through card. When the experience becomes solid, it becomes just like wireless internet access. Now you know, God, I can do it. I am doing it. So if kids realize 1 or 2 miracles, then suddenly they know they can do it and they are doing it. They are doing it. Awaken the true potential just by clearly understanding. Nothing else. I tell you, the best thing can be done by a human being is living in a community where intelligence and enlightenment is in the waves, in the air. I tell you, not for promoting my sangha with any money, with any luxury, with any comfort. Man cannot experience pleasure more than 6 points in the body. 5 senses and the heart, 6th point, that's all. But only in an intelligent community where everything is centered on enlightenment, where the idea of enlightenment is constantly in the air, where you are hearing about it every day at least 20 times, where you are thinking about it at least 100 times a day, where constantly you are bombarded with these truths, you will have the pleasure in all points of your life. I tell you, either become part of the community which is enlightenment based. If you can't, at least wherever you stay, wherever you live, create a community around you which is enlightenment based. Even if they are little less than your strength, your knowledge, create. So that they will be constantly reminding you when you go low. The Jains have a great habit. Jain monks, they will not eat in anybody's house other than their sampradaya, their tradition. I also wanted all our ashramites to start this as a habit. Don't eat in any other place other than our devotee's house. Means what? You will create the enlightenment based community wherever you are, just as a survival need. Eating means what? Sharing your time, sharing your understanding, sharing your friendship. Eating, with eating, so many hundreds of things happen. Understand? Eating is not just little food and you swallow and go. No. With eating, hundreds of socio, politico, economic, so many things happen. Much can happen over a cup of coffee. So eating means not just an ordinary taking. There is so much of psychological connection. So many other things happens just with eating, sharing of food. So decide. So today I am giving this as an understanding to all our ashramites and devotees and disciples and swamis and brahmacharis. Make this as a point. Avoid eating as much as possible other than the places of our devotees. Of course, I use the word as much as possible because I included the devotees also. Only for devotees the word as much as possible applies. Not for the ashramites, brahmacharis and sannyasis and rishis. For them it should be eat only in our devotees' places. So you are bound to create communities, the enlightened communities, constantly. The enlightenment based groups, teams, friends. Understand? More than what you eat, what you talk during eating plays an important role. With whom you are eating plays an important role. What are you planning? Whatever you are planning while eating or taking bath will be executed in your life without your knowledge. Understand? Whatever you plan, you think during taking bath or eating will be executed in your life without you realizing. Before even you realize that this is what you are thinking trend. That is why I insist on taking bath in the sacred water. Bodies. That's the right word. The sacred water bodies. Like Ganga. The temple tank. The sacred water bodies. Plays a major role in making your thoughts into reality. That is the purpose I created this Vaidya Sarovar. And everybody uses that sacred water bodies for regular bath. So much can happen in you. I know the power of taking bath in sacred water bodies. At least once a day. Whatever you think during taking bath or eating just becomes reality in your life. Live in an enlightenment based community as much as possible. Ramakrishna says, if you drank half a liter arak, at least drink 1/10 liter, 100 ml, the water from the rice cooking. If you drink that water, rice ganji, that arak effect will go away. Same way, if you live 1 year in the society, getting into all the corruption and nuisance and nonsense, at least come and spend 21 days in an enlightened community. enlightenment community. At least come and spend 21 days so that all the effect of the arak leaves your system. All the effect of the society leaves your system. You become more pure. So live in enlightenment based community as much as possible. And wherever you are staying, create an enlightenment based community. Even casually in the parties where people talk about these great things. Not that same foolish nonsense of what is your stock, where is your share value, what is going on with that jewelry, this sari, that cinema. Ramakrishna says, if somebody talks about the worldly things, I feel they are pouring the molten lead in my ears. I can't tolerate, I run away from that place. Let you create a community where constantly the enlightenment based ideas are spoken, exchanged, shared, lived, loved. I tell you, that's the greatest thing you can do for yourself. If you all the people below 14 should live in an enlightenment based community where many people already awakened their non-mechanical parts of the brain are working to awaken the non-mechanical parts of the brain. So last 20 years you should live in a place where people live the depressionless, peaceful, healthy old age. Between that time of 14 and last 20 years, live in a place where enlightenment based civilization exists. It means what? From birth to death, be with the master. That's what I am saying with so many different words. Start living in enlightenment communities as much as possible. Start creating enlightenment based communities as much as possible. After all, now I made creating enlightenment based community as such a simple franchisee project. See, all the tools necessary are available. We made a clearly already franchisee document available. Whole thing is available on YouTube. Whether it is a form of rituals or form of meditations, form of spiritual ideas, whole thing is available in YouTube now. You guys don't even need to feel that you have to be bound physically in Bidhi. Wherever you are, create a franchisee. Franchisee and community. That's what I call N Satsang Centers. Make people more and more interested. These YouTube discourses, books and all that, that's all. Don't think, no, people are very foolish, they are not interested. No, you not tried. People are surely more intelligent than you. When people like you can get interested into enlightenment, surely people whom you think are dull or foolish than you are intelligent. You are not told in right way. Maybe when you tell, you are talking more about you than about me. Hide you, put me. You will see, they will become interested. They will start creating an enlightenment in them. So at least for your health's sake, create N communities around the world. Let the kids live in enlightenment based communities. Let elders live in enlightenment based communities. Let the middle aged people live in enlightenment based communities. And not only that, even in the communities, enlightenment based communities, let us add more and more enlightenment into actions. More and more of these truths into actions. understand about your brain not as a personal computer but as a laptop with internet connection, wireless internet connection, and awaken its true potential. Live and radiate enlightenment. Let you all live and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
Dream.